and straightforward, and not afraid to say what's important to her, even if this puts her in a vulnerable position. Whether writing a rap song about her most personal struggles, or stating her perspective on a contentious musical issue in ensembles, Rose is articulate, but at the same time open to hearing others' perspectives. Rose has contributed in many ways to the Riverstone community, from helping grow the Sonic Club and Melodics Club, engineering sound for several variety shows, and countless Riverstone and community events. I've been consistently impressed with Rose's patience and focus on encouraging and supporting new sound and stage crew members. I remember several times when a less experienced student made an error that Rose quietly resolved without calling the student out, and instead just focused on helping them improve. Rose has many passions, but one of them is the relatively obscure realm of mashup music. Mashup artists take elements of multiple recordings and tie them in a new way to create new artistic works. Rose's EE focused on the historical development of mashup music, yes, it has a history, from the 1970s to the present. Her excellent research touched on technical and structural issues as well as social and political commentary. She is able to give specific and helpful feedback to fellow students in discussions. I remember one class when we were peer editing students' rough drafts of EDM and other like drawing pieces. One student had a lot of really good material and was asking the class for help in making the final end sound just right. But instead of really jumping in and giving advice, Rose patiently asked the student about her goals for the piece, and then made specific suggestions for how to achieve these goals. Never once getting her opinion and staying entirely focused on helping that other student achieve their vision. Rose, you are able to stay true to yourself and your strong views and perspectives while still remaining open to others. Keep that. Keep helping others reach their own vision even as you reach yours. I'm so excited to see you follow your artistic vision in college. I can't wait to listen to your tracks.
Thank you so much, Mr. Brown, for those amazing words. And I have a lot of credit that is due to so many people. Like my very classy classmates, more or less classy, that is. My tireless teachers who great stacks of homework and go through tons and tons of evaluations until you nail it. And my parents for staying with us even when maybe I have five projects that are due tomorrow that I'm not started on. That was a frustration. But I mean this. It's such a unique school, such a unique place to just be. I mean, I can't think of any other school that like your friends with your teachers, essentially. I mean, it's just amazing. I mean, so in a way, our class is very largely made up of people who are not from the United States. But and in a sense, I see myself as an exchange student from a faraway land of upstate New York. I mean, in seventh grade, Idaho was just a word that just caused giggles. And I thought that Boise was pronounced boys. But by the time eighth grade rolled around, my family and I had dropped everything to come out here because we saw something in this place. With small classes, rigorous education, and honestly, I've been able to get so deep in so many subjects. I've been able to combine, Mr. Brown said, combine my passions and schoolwork. I wrote an essay that went off the IB about Pokemon. I mean, it's great. I mean, even things that maybe might not seem academic, you can make something out of it here, and that's really what I love. I mean, and so graduating class is following Mars will be much larger. Sorry, Sammy. And we were the last class not to be split into two during middle school. The last class to remember what it was like to have a field of grass to play on. And sadly, the last class to graduate under the benevolent Bob Harrigan. But I know that we won't be the last class to walk in the footsteps of giants. We'll not be the last class to succeed in robotics, esports, whatever we go after. And you know, we won't be the last class to share the classroom with